Welcome to the Grenier Space Programme. Now, I know there's a lot of you degenerate fecks out there that just like blowing shit up. This is a weapon that will send trash into space. No forms needed filling out, no permission needed either, just send them airborne. Cartwheeling dudes everywhere, and a truckload of red crits and explosions. Tog would be happy. Welcome on in, you beautiful feckers, how you all do? Now, this weapon is a serious amount of fun. I think that's the key word with the Kuva Chakor. To hell with damage, to hell with stats, it's just pure fun. Where size, I guess, really does matter. Kind of looks like a candy cane or an umbrella handle as well. Now, don't get me wrong, it hits like a truck, bloody hard as well. Has a lot of positives, but also some negatives to go with it. It's not overpowered, don't worry about it getting nerfed, because I know someone's probably typing it already. It has got those negatives, but the red crits and the blast damage is really, really nice. High damage and a mixture of crowd control all rolled into one. Now, this weapon and the Kuva Comb are the two weapons that I really wanted to get my hands on from the Kuva Liches. Maybe even, I'm going to regret saying this, but maybe even the Kuva Kraken, because it's meant to be amazing. Blasphemy, I know, just don't tell anyone, right? Shh, never said it. So what's so good about the Kuva Chakor, apart from launching trash enemies? 125% crit chance with just point strike, making it the joint top crit weapon in the game. Solid crit damage multiplier and a 27% status chance as well. The based blast damage for this weapon is also thrown in for good measure. Also, from what I believe, this weapon is great, or at least it's good for Eidolon hunting, if you get the bonus as radiation damage. Now, it is a Grenier flintlock rifle, I guess, like the Grinlock and things like that, that uses sniper ammo. Mastery rank 13. Mine, however, has a bonus to toxin damage. It has a fast enough projectile speed, creates explosions, like I said, on hit with a 5-meter radius to those explosions, and it has bonkers crit stats. But on the downside, it also has a bad reload speed. Feels like it needs to be modded for that reload speed or buffed by a Warframe ability to increase it. It's got a slow fire rate. You have a second between each shot. And like I said, it is a projectile-based weapon, which means leading your targets or else you're going to miss shots. Now, equipping the Vigilante mods on your Sentinel weapon and, of course, your Warframe will make the Chakor absolutely shine. It's the reason I'm getting so many red crits. This is my current mod setup for this weapon, complete with mods equipped on my Sentinel. If you equip all of the Vigilante mods, it will give you a bonus of 30% chance to boost your crits from yellow to orange or orange to red and so on. Vigilante Supplies is also an incredible mod to put in your auxiliary slot for this weapon for a constant supply of sniper ammo, since it is a rare ammo type, so it's definitely worth equipping that. Now, Argon Scope, bladed rounds are completely up to you. Hunter Munitions is as well. Or if you want to stick on an extra heat mod for increased armor stripping, entirely up to the user. But like I said, if you can get a Kuva Chakor with bonus radiation damage, if you're into Eidolon hunting, then it's meant to be really, really worth it. Now, it has got a neutral Riven disposition for now, and I say that because I would imagine it would get a pass at some point in the future. But let me know in the comment section below what you think of the Kuva Chakor. Based on the footage you've seen, if you don't have your hands on one, or if you're on console still waiting for that update, I believe it's going to cert pretty soon. Or if you do have one and you've got a different element on it, maybe radiation, and you have hunted some of the Eidolons, how does it feel? Is it strong? Let me know. Do me a huge favor and hit that like button if you enjoyed the video, or don't if you didn't. Subscribe for more Warframe, and as always, thanks very much for watching.